mm-hmm. on the same page. Mm-hmm. So if you want to do the first ring, ignore that italics, mm-hmm. arrange mm-hmm. that scroll to them straight down the word of the word. And then two of you sit together while they sing the psalm.
Yeah.
And then come up and do the second ring, but again, just ignore that italics mm-hmm. and just read down there. And then as soon as you're finished, both of you can write down the way you came. Mm-hmm. And just adjust this. For yourselves. And it'll pick you up. You don't need to be right into it if you're standing up.
Yeah.
Straight up, it'll pick you up all right. Okay, and that'll be totally fine.
Okay, that's fine.
So do you want me around to have a look at them, or are you happy with them?
I'm okay, thanks, man.
Take your time, that's all you do.
Yeah, take
a breath.
Take a breath, you'll be fine.
I'll be fine.
Good morning. Thanks. And welcome to our funeral mass this morning. For a minute there, I thought I was going to have mass outside, but we got you in, so that's good. Well done. On behalf of Mary's family, thank you all for your presence here, for the not just your presence, but also your words of comfort and your prayers. And that's principally what we're here to do, is to remember her and to pray for her. For anyone who's not been to Mass for a while due to the pandemic, the restrictions are pretty much lifted. So you'll see that there's very few specific things we have to think about. For communion, Deacon Bill and I will give out communion. We'll still wear face coverings. So we'll sanitise our hands and we'll wear face coverings. And I would ask you to receive communion on your hand. If you wish to receive communion on your tongue, then wait to the very end and you'll see there's two or three people will come forward and receive communion at that point. And you're welcome if you wish to do that if you come to me. At the same time, if there's anyone who's not receiving communion that wishes to receive a blessing, you're more than welcome to come forward to receive that, and either Deacon Bill or I can give you that blessing. You just come forward at the same time as everybody else and cross your arms in front of you like that, and then we know to give you the blessing. And I'll remind you of that when it comes to communion time itself.
be with you. You will never sink beneath the waves. Do not be afraid, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by your name. You are mine. When the fire is burning all around you, you will never be consumed by the flames. Do not be afraid.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with you.
Later on this year, the parish is going to Lourdes on pilgrimage, and a few of us will be going there to the place where Our Lady appeared to Bernadette. And one of the things we'll do is you take intentions, you take prayer intentions for different people. And I'm pretty sure that one of the first intentions that we'll be given is Mary, is to pray for her. And because I already know, speaking to you, about the great devotion that she had to Our Lady and particular experiences of travelling to Lourdes as well. And that's why I've worn the Marian vestment today, and this is the month of Our Lady. It's the month of May. What we're doing here today is, as you gather to remember someone that you love, you remember also her deep faith, her trust in God, and her prayers to Mary and asking Mary's intercession. And so this time round, we do it for her. We pray to the Lord for her. We ask Mary's intercession for our sister, that she will help her on that journey to the Lord. And we'll hear in the Gospel Christ speak about friendship. He speaks about friendship, not master-servant, but the relationship is of a friend. And it's very clear that Mary was friends with Christ and knew him well. And that's why we can start by saying, do not be afraid. There's nothing to worry about. There's nothing to fear. Instead, she's received into the arms of a friend now as she comes before the Lord. And what we're here to do is to remember her, to remind ourselves of the resurrection and of her faith, and to pray for Mary. Every prayer that we make for her helps her on that journey to the Father. And so that we can do that well, we begin by asking forgiveness for our sins. Lord Jesus, your mighty God and Prince of Peace, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, your Son of God and Son of Mary, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, your Word made flesh and splendor of the Father, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Listen kindly to our prayers, O Lord. As our faith in your Son raised from the dead is deepened, may our hope of resurrection for your departed servant Mary also find new strength. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
And would you sit down for our readings now?
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. The life and death of each of us has its influence on others. If we live, we live for the Lord. If we die for the Lord. So that alive or dead, we belong to the Lord. This explains why Christ both died and came to life. It was so that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living. We shall all have to stand before the judgment seat of God. as scripture says, be my life. It is the Lord who speaks. Every knee shall bend before me, and every tongue shall praise God. It is God, therefore, that each of us must give an account of himself. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Shelter of the Lord, who abide in his shadow for life. Say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock in whom I trust, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you you, and famine will bring you no fear. Under his wings, your refuge, his faithfulness, your shield, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings. A stone, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Death is swallowed up in victory. I will tell you something that has been a secret. We are not all going to die, but we shall all be changed. This will be instantaneous, in the twinkling of an eye. When the last trumpet sounds, it will sound, and the dead will be raised imperishable. And we shall be changed as well, because our present perishable nature must put on an imperishability, and this mortal nature must put on immortality. When this perishable nature has put on imperishability, and when this mortal nature has put on immortality, then the words of Scripture will come true. Death is swallowed up in victory. Death, where is your victory? Death, where is your sting? Now the sting of death is sin, and sin gets its power from the law. So let us thank God for giving us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "This is my commandment, love one another as I have loved you. A man can have no greater love than to lay down his life for his friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I shall not call you servants anymore, because a servant does not know his master's business. I call you friends because I have made known to you everything I have learnt from my Father. You did not choose me, no, I chose you, and I commissioned you to go out and to bear fruit, fruit that will last, and then the Father will give you anything you ask him in my name. What I command you is to love one another." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
Would you sit down, please? I invited you to write a few things down about Mary, about your mum. And when we do that, we usually start with kind of dates and places and things like that. And those are just bare facts, but those bare facts then contain an awful lot of history, an awful lot of stories behind that. So just being born in 1947 in Maryhill to her parents John and Elizabeth, and the oldest of nine children. And then her schooling at St. Augustine's. Then get on to opening our own hair salon in Glasgow. See, when you do that, you start to feel self-conscious, don't you? Think, oh, sugar, I should have checked this. And then Con comes in 1968. I like the way you're honest to say she wasn't that keen. And she wasn't looking for a second date, but Con persevered and made Mary laugh. And then they became great people together, you know? And so well done for your perseverance, Con, in that regard. And then the two of you together, the life you lived and your working life in the licensed trade managing pubs together. But that wouldn't matter as much as the children that you would have, Sharon, Lindsay and Siobhan, and then fostering and adopting Andrew as well. And all of that contains a history and a story. Con, you seem to get it in the neck here a bit though, because they do say that lots of shopping and lots of making sure you didn't know exactly how much they spent on the shopping as well. And then once the grandchildren come along, the children are forgotten. That's the deal. And so Connor and Cameron, Cara, Lauren and Declan. And what a lovely thing to say. She helped shape them into the people they are today. Do you know, that's such a really important thing. What a great thing to be able to say about somebody, she had an influence. And what was that reading that we listened to from St. Paul? The life and death of each of us has its influence on others. And so one of the things I get the feeling you're doing a lot of reflecting on is the influence that Mary had. And also, don't just think about the influence that she had, but the influence she'll continue to have. And that's an important thing for us to reflect on as well. And, you know, you just say simple things, but that would mean a lot, being at a caravan on holiday, in the sun, pottering about in the garden, all these things. They just bring pictures to mind. You know, when you tell stories, you'll have pictures and different snapshots that you have that then come to you, and each of you will have different ones. And what you do is together you share the stories. And you create the picture of that person's life together. And the last bit, I think, is worth reading in its entirety. Most significant was Mary's strength. In the face of her illness, which blighted her life for many years, she was determined not to allow this to define her, but instead found an unyielding belief in her faith. She was driven by her love for Our Lady and devotion to Padre Pio, and never feared what was to come. That must be why I said that thing at the start. Never feared what was to come because of her relationship to God. The other day when you asked me to come into the home to be with you and with Mary, Con told a story. And so because Con told it, it was a long story. And it took a while. You're thinking, to interrupt? No, it's not. Let him go. But it was a really profound story. And it was the story of Lourdes. I mentioned Lourdes at the start. And you said that a while ago, and on a trip to Lourdes and having gone by bus, and those bus journeys were brutal. And by the time you got to Lourdes, the first thing you'd probably want is to just go and get washed up. I'd want to go for a pint, but that's just me. But the first thing that Mary wanted to do was get down to the grotto. And before anything happened, that's what she wanted to do, because she had a pile of petitions. I mentioned petitions. She had a pile of intentions. She had people that she'd gone there to pray for. And so that was first in her mind, that obligation she had to pray for all of those intentions was the one thing that drove her. And so she went straight down to the grotto, and she sat there and took her time to pray for all those people. Problem was, nobody knew where she was, so they ended up nearly sending out a search party because she was there for hours. And that just reflects what a prayer life she must have had, to be so caught up in her prayers and with Our Lady there. That must have been, she must have had a deep, deep, genuine faith. And that's such an important thing for us to be able to reflect on today. And a friendship with Christ. That's what I spoke about. Do you know, the friendship that you had with her, the relationships that you had with her are important. As children, grandchildren, sister, friend, all of these things. Wife as well. I can't let it pass without referring to Con's hair and the back of that order of service. That is a fine thing. There, Con, there's... Sorry about that, but... Because they're lovely pictures. Do you know? They are. And it's good. You laugh and cry at the same time. That's what you do. It's deep emotion that you feel. And that's because you love her. Not loved her, but love her. And so that emotion means that you're going to cry and you're going to laugh. And that's great. If you didn't love her, you'd be sitting there quite calm and not too worried. But the love that you have is obvious and deep and intense. And then to be taken in by who she was. As I said, I didn't have the privilege of seeing this great, the strength that she would have had and the faith that she would have had and the influence that she obviously had. But reflect on that and take that to heart. And what's really important, don't just be impressed by that. Be inspired by it. To be impressed is just to stand at a distance and say, isn't that really good? To be inspired is to say, no, I'd like to be a bit like that. And take all the best bits and say, I would like to live up to those. And in particular, in this place, her faith. That faith that took her through so many difficult times. And it's one of the things we learn as Christians is that for some reason, God doesn't take us round it. And he doesn't always take it away, but he does take us by the hand, does take us through it. And it sounds like Mary very much understood that. And that she understood the basics of her faith, which is that Christ died and rose again for our sake. That he died on the cross because he loves her. He didn't die on the cross for some unnamed group of people. In this case, right now, Christ died on the cross for Mary. And she knew that. And he rose again for Mary. And she knew that as well. And that now she will see him face to face. And that if we can talk about God taking her by the hand through the difficulties of this life, we can talk very clearly about God taking her by the hand right now to the place prepared for her. If this was her unshaking faith, then be inspired by that. And ask God to give you a little bit of that. And now we pray for her, but then she's going to go and pray for you. So all that those petitions and intentions that she had, she'll have them again, because those in heaven that we love are there praying for us, and you've got her there to rely on to pray for you. But you have the job to pray for her now and to be inspired by her. Thank God for her. It sounds like she was a gift to you. Thank God for that gift, and then live up to that in faith and in love. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace. Amen. And may her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Would you stand, please? God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ, his Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save all his people, living and dead.
For Mary, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For our sister, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that she may be raised up on the last day. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of our sister Mary, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. And let's ask Our Lady's intercession. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now, and at the hour of our death. Amen. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed sister Mary. Cleanse her and all the faithful departed of their sins, and grant them the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Would you sit down for our offertory procession now? My brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
The Lord has the
Look favourably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant Mary may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended, and when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy,
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 holy
Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. And if you can, would you kneel down, please? You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Bernadette and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Mary, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
And would you stand, please? At the Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your
spirit. Lamb of God. And would you kneel down, please? Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be
remind you of what I said before Mass began. During the distribution of Holy Communion, if there's anyone who wishes to receive a blessing, you're welcome. Just come forward at the same time as everyone else, and if you cross your arms in front of you like that, we'll know to give you the blessing. Would you like to sit up now, please?
Ave Maria.
Let's stand and pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Mary, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
With faith in Jesus Christ, we must reverently bury the body of our sister. Let us pray with confidence to God, in whose sight all creation lives, that he will raise up in holiness and power the mortal body of our sister and command her soul to be numbered among the blessed. May God grant her a merciful judgment, deliverance from death and pardon of sin. May Christ the Good Shepherd carry her home to be at peace with the Father. May she rejoice forever in the presence of the Eternal King and in the company of all the saints. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Mary, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon her in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us to remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ, and are with you and with our sister forever. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto her, Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace. Amen. And may her soul, and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. In peace let us take Mary to her place of rest. May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem.